In this presentation, I want to take the concept of web request and web response a little bit further. And I want to talk to you about the elements in the page that will allow the user to interact with the page, triggering this request response behavior. Let's take Google again as an example. And if you look at the Google page, you have buttons and links. Let's take the typical example of this page, which is the user searches for some text. And once the user hits the search button right here, a web request is going to be sent somewhere to the web. Here's the web that is going to get me a response. Sorry, let me use another color here. A response with a web page. And this web page will perhaps contain a list of results that are in fact links. The user can then click one of these links and another web request is going to be made to the web. Another request, and then the consequence of a request is another response. And the response would be another web page, perhaps with the result of what the user was trying to get, to search in the first place. So to recap this, there's a web request when the user hits the search button, which triggers then, so this is number one. Number two is a web response. And then when the user clicks one of the results, another, that's number three, another web request will be sent to the web, which will then result in another web response. So that's the web request response dynamics triggered by some of the elements in your page, such as links and buttons.